harder it gets. We called it magic, then we called it tragic. Finally, we called it quits. It's always been harder to fall out of love than fall in. I don't know where I'm going, but I doubt if I'll ever forget where I've been. We couldn't call it happy, though it was for a while. We couldn't call it sad, cause it taught us both to smile. For lack of a better word to call it, we called it quits. Quit, quit, we called it quit. It sounds like the easy way out, but oh, when it fits. The longer you live with someone you can't live with, the harder it gets. We called it lovely, then we called it lonely. Finally, we called it quit. We called it magic, then we called it tragic. Finally, we called it quits.
Hey, okay, that was Bill Anderson and We Called It Quits. Just a, we'll call it an extra that we threw in here on the show. Well, I've got one for all the guys over there. Dick, Bob, Ron, Don, and you too, Mike. This is some good gossip, gang.
Now, Miss Nancy Ann ran a boarding house with a faded sign that read, single rooms for single girls, no men allowed, it said. But rumor had it that a gentleman with a yen for love for a fee could always go to Nancy Ann's for some feminine company. Well, one night in June in the billiard room, I was chalking up with a friend. He was set to break when the door burst open and Leo James rushed in. He yelled, there's a fire that's just broke out and it's down at Nancy Ann's. So we dropped our cues on the pool room floor and into the street we ran. Though the flames were hot and the smoke was thick, not a single act was lost, and the reason for the blaze was never found. But it alone will be remembered in our local history as a fire that fairly scandalized the town. The night Miss Nancy Ann's hotel for single girls burned down. When we got to the place, the front was ablaze, and so was the second floor. So we cut around the side and up the alley and stopped beside the back door. We were catching our breath when the door flew open and knocked poor Leo flat. And out through the smoke ran Mayor Wills wearing nothing but a black silk hat. And right behind him with his shirt tail afire came the local chief of police. Then Banker Jones with a red-haired girl he always called his niece. Then I spied Miss Nancy Ann herself helping someone out of the fire. Her arm around the red bald head of old Judge McIntyre. A deacon, a dentist, a deputy sheriff, and one state congressman. The county physician, the city mortician, out through the flames they ran. A grand parade of girls in gowns and half-clad gentlemen. Through thick gray smoke that sweetly smelled of French perfume and gin. Though the flames were hot and the smoke was thick, not a single life was lost. And the reason for the blaze was never found. But it alone will be remembered in our local history as the fire that fairly scandalized the town. The night Miss Nancy Ann's hotel for single girls burned down. Now everybody was out of the girls' hotel by the time the roof caved in. We were heading back to the billiard hall when Leo turned to my friend. He said, I believe that's the funniest show I've ever seen in town. The so-called elite caught out in the street with their pompous security down. Though the flames were hot and the smoke was thick, not a single laugh was lost. And the reason for the blaze was never found. But it alone will be remembered in our local history as a fire that fairly scandalized the town. The night Miss Nancy Ann's hotel for single girls burned down.
Tex Ritter with a Rated X song for the guys. The night Miss Nancy Ann's hotel for single girls burned down. Okay, let's play one for the girls so we don't start any family feuds. So here's one for Diane, Judy, Dolly, and of course, you, Donna.
There's a picture that we took in Cincinnati. The time we saw that big league baseball game. Here's a picture that we took in Printer's Alley. Down in Nashville when we met old what's his name.
Here's one of me in my old 60 Chevy. The one that led us down in Baltimore.
Here's the best one that I've ever seen of Betty. And can you believe the dresses that you wore? Here's a picture that we took at graduation. I'm so glad you talked me out of quitting school. Here I am when I worked at the filling station. And here's one of Ernie acting like a fool.
Here's the last one that we ever took of Daddy. We tried hard to make him smile, but never did.
And here's one I called of you when you weren't ready. And here I am when I was just a kid.
Oh, sweetheart, it's so much fun to be reminded of how we used to look and what we used to do. And each time we make a memory, I'm reminded I can't picture me with no one else but you. Here's a pose of you that looks so sweet and lovely. That's the way I picture you right from the start. And here's a picture of you being close beside me. That's the picture that I carry in my heart.
Oh, sweetheart, it's so much fun to be reminded of how we used to look and what we used to do. And each time we make a memory, I'm reminded I can't picture me with no one else but you.
Hey, that was the Statler Brothers and Pictures, a kind of a reminiscing tune, and I know all women like to reminisce, so we played that one for you.
The swinging door is always open when you listen to Air Force Sergeant Don Cotterell on the Down and Country radio program daily on the American Forces Vietnam Network.
Okay, let's throw in one more comedy cut before we get out of here. This is Jerry Reed. Have another puff. That's for all the smokers in the crowd.
I know there's a lot of talk going around today. A lot of cigarette smoking, whittling your life away. I've seen it and I've heard it so many times that finally it just started to prey on my mind. I guess it scared me a little bit. That's why I decided I was gonna quit. So while I was sitting here forming my battle plan, I took another puff and turned on the fan. I just sat there in my easy chair, thought of all the money I'd wasted on cigarettes all these years. I thought I'd spend the rest of my days after I kicked this habit my body craved. Said to myself, this ain't gonna be so tough. With that little bit of assurance, I took another puff. I took a puff. Then I ripped off another puff. I decided I about had enough. That breaking this habit won't be too tough. Now I'll give a lot of thought to this thing. If I didn't smoke cigarettes, I'd feel just like a king. Tired with the price going up every day, I knew I was just throwing all my good money away. You know, I ain't lit one an hour or so. Just wanted to make sure I could quit, you know. I was thinking maybe I ought to write all this down, put it in a song. Kind of circulated around. Can't ever tell them I'd make a hit. And I'd have to call it a little bit. Can you imagine me, a hit songwriter? I wish I swear I'd put that cigarette lighter. After all, it's a habit and a habit you can break. Just a little bit of willpower, son. That's all it takes. I said to myself, you've got to be tough. And with that little bit of wisdom, I took another puff. I took a puff, and then a puff. And I finally ripped off another puff, and I decided, boy, this ain't gonna be tough. So I just about had enough. I'm about ready to quit this riding habit anyway. Oh, I think they ought to take it off television. It looks too good. Maybe I'll eat. Maybe I'll eat cigarettes. Oh, I love it, 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 I love it. Chester B. don't smoke. He smokes logs. Makes you laugh funny, too. Oh, my throat's scratching. Oh. I wish I could think of something bad to say about cigarettes. Boo on cigarettes. Don't smoke, don't smoke, don't smoke. You quit smoking, that'd leave more for me. I love it, I love it. No, I don't love cigarettes. You know, I misunderstand. I hate cigarettes. It makes you cough. And when you don't smoke, it makes you shake. I don't know what's worse, to shake or to cough. I think it'll make me a cough shake. Oh! Did you ever smoke? Oh, I remember one time I quit smoking. I quit for 3 months. My wife left. So did my children. She took my house and left. It was a mobile home.
Okay, that just about winds things up here on this Don Gum Radio Show. That was Jerry Reed and Have Another Pup. I'd like to talk to Mike right now. Mike, I put together a production, you know, since you left here, and I thought you might like a copy of it. If you don't, you can just cut it off at the end of the tape, because that's where I'm going to put it, right here on the end of the tape. And we call this the chain of command. And for your own information, the commander would not let me air this one. The chain of command. A general flies as high as the mightiest rocket. Is more powerful than the heaviest locomotive. Faster than speeding bullets, walks on water, and gives policy guidance to God. Bird Colonel flies as high as transport, is as powerful as a switch engine. As fast as a speeding bullet, walks on still water on a calm day, and talks with God, but listens attentively. Lieutenant Colonel jumps over tall buildings with a single bound.
Look, up there in the sky, look!
It's a squatty thing!
Is it a chicken?
No, no, it's Pantywave!
Is as strong as an army jeep. Is a bit faster than a BB. Gets wet up to his ankles when walking on water. And talks to God with permission. Major! Can jump over Quonset huts with a long run and favorable winds. Is powerful enough to get dressed by himself, that is, if he eats his Wheaties. Can't handle a rifle and ammunition. Is authorized in a swimming pool. And talks to the animals.
I've learned to speak in antelope and turtle. My Pekingese would be extremely good.
Captain. Runs into buildings when trying to enter them. Can get dressed with supervision and help. Can tell the difference between a water pistol and a handgun 2 times out of 3. And talks to the wall.
Yeah, holy mackerel there. Hello, wall.
First Lieutenant. Can identify buildings. Plays with toy trains. Shoots himself when playing with a cork gun. Can walk in indoor wading pool and talks to his teddy bear. Second Lieutenant.
Dynamite.
Is not allowed outdoors. Most likely potty trained. Plays in the bathtub.
Lucky, you're so fine. I'm lucky that you're mine. Lucky, I'm like a whole panda.
And says goo goo dada sometimes. Sergeant flies higher and farther than the mightiest rocket. Kicks trains off the tracks with his left foot. Lifts buildings and walks under. Catches bullets and chews them out. And freezes water with a single glance. Is God.